Friday Night Heights in the loveliest village on the plains, the newly named Neville Arena, hosting the top gymnastics meet in the SEC. It's the number 3 Florida Gators against the number 6 Auburn Tigers. The Florida Gators have already clinched a share of the SEC regular season championship. Tonight, the Tigers have a chance to make history. With an Auburn win, the Auburn Tigers can clinch their first share of SEC tournament of SEC gymnastics regular season. Hello, everybody, and welcome inside Neville Arena. I'm Britt Bowen alongside Toy Garcia. And Toy, boy, do we have a fun one here tonight. How do you set this one up as two of the best gymnastics teams in the SEC?
Britt, I'm so excited. It's alumni night, it's senior night, and it's just a huge meet for NCAA gymnastics in general.
Well, if you look at the stars for this meet, Florida and Auburn have them both. I mean, they have two of the best all-around athletes in Trinity Thomas and Suni Lee this season.
These are stellar athletes on their respective teams and in the NCAA in general. I'm really excited to see some good scores tonight and just outstanding performances.
Well, the Auburn Tigers going to get us started off on the vault in the first rotation. And the Florida Gators will be on bars for Auburn. It'll be Sophia Groth to lead it off. What do you think of this lineup tonight for Auburn?
Auburn vault lineup, we're going to see 6-10-0 start values, which is the first time we will see that from this team this season. First vault, it's a Yurchenko vault. She absolutely sticks it. I'm screaming right now because the energy in here is crazy. It's so loud. A perfect way for Auburn to start off on vault.
Stellar start for the Tigers. Now it's the Gators' turn on bars. Here to get us going, and for the Florida Gators, here's your lineup tonight on the bars. As for the Gators, it will be Sloan Blakely to lead things off, and boy, Blakely, she is one of the best in the SEC at what she does.
Good cast handstand to start the routine right on top of the bar. First major release there is a Shirpash into a pack salto. It's a good connection that'll earn her some good points. Moving up to the high bar, nice handstand right on top of the bar. That's what the judges are looking for. Moving into the dismount. Blind landing dismount, and she sticks it. Blind landings are so difficult because you can't see the floor as you land, and she handled that with no problem. Let's take another look here at her dismount. It's a double front dismount. She eases right into it. You can see she was actually looking for her feet as she lands, and she handled it perfectly.
That was Sloan Blakely, the freshman out of Frisco, Texas. That'll bring up Cassie Stevens for the Auburn Tigers. And for Stevens, she's competed in every meet this year for the Tigers.
So excited right now to see Cassie on vault. She will be doing a 10-0 start while Yurchenko 1.5, which she hasn't competed yet this season. Looking for good entry onto the table, amplitude, and a stuck landing. Oh, and she just absolutely nails it. Exactly what she wanted to do.
And the Tigers explode for the junior out of Phoenix, Arizona, Cassie Stevens. That's back-to-back solid performances for the Tigers on vault.
Back-to-back stuck landings, and at this point, in NCAA, the judges are looking for the small, small details, the legs together, the stuck landing. That will be the difference between the team that wins.
Riley McCusker, another freshman up for the Florida Gators. She had a 9.925 as a career high against Arkansas.
Nice pack salto to a Shapash. Major release, good connection there. And she slips up a little bit. Wasn't supposed to go over the bar on that handstand. That'll count as a fall. That is 5/10 off her score.
And Toy, now it's time to regroup as a gymnast. How do you reset yourself in this event?
So important to regroup because this routine might count. They might have another fall throughout their lineup, so you never know. It's good to go back into what you do in practice and just bring that right into the arena. A little squatting on that landing. Looks like she got a little bit into her head.
Well.
Clearly upset. Nice pack salto, but then she trips up just a little here. She wasn't able to get completely over the bar on that, just kind of falls right out of it.
Well, McCusker, don't let that performance fool you. She placed fourth on bars at the U.S. Olympic Trials. And next up for the Tigers, it will be Sarah Hubbard for Auburn. And for Hubbard, she's one that head coach Jeff Graba talked highly of this week.
I just want to remind our viewers, the judges are looking for speed, quickness, and explosive power on this event. Yurchenko full, nicely done. Huge ball. Kenzie, we'll take another look here. She does take a hop out of her landing. See that hop out of her landing? That'll be a couple tenths deduction there, but a solid ball all around.
Hubbard coming off that career high on balls just last week. And it's back to the bars for the Gators. It'll be Savannah Shane here. Shane here, a three-time All-American in her time as a Florida Gator. And she's from right down the road, Columbus, Georgia.
So far, so good. First major release there. Little Archie on that handstand, but she was able to save it. One thing I noticed about this athlete is she has beautiful lines on this event. Handstand right on top of the bar. Gearing up for the dismount here. It's another double front with a half out. Stutter steps a little bit on that landing there. I'm sure that's not what she was anticipating or wanting, but so far, solid performance.
Florida head coach Jenny Rowland said that landings will be important in this meet. That's what it's going to come down to. Your thoughts on that, Toy?
Absolutely. At this point in the season, it's the details that matter. The landings. Those small tenth deductions add up, and that's the difference between the winner.
Here you hear the roar for Darion Goborn. She was the 2019 vault national champion, the first ever for the Auburn Tigers.
You can see she has a really good entry onto the table, nice block off of the table, which gives her a lot of amplitude and height, distance off the horse. We'll take another look here. It's a major vault, huge vault. Just as a settling on that landing, she was a little bit of, had stutter steps on that landing there, and that'll be a couple tenths off. You can see there how high she is off the table. It looks easy, but I promise you, it's not.
Darion Goborn for the Auburn Tigers. Now it's back to a six-time All-American graduate out of Marietta, Georgia, and Megan Skaggs. She had a season-high 9.90 last week on this event against Oklahoma.
Nice, solid handstand right on top of the bar to a huge Takaka major release into an immediate pack salto. Heading right back up to the high bar. The nice solid handstand right on top. Gearing up for the dismount as she accelerates those giants. It's a double layout. And she sticks that landing. Nicely done.
And you can easily see why Skaggs, a six-time All-American for the Florida Gators.
Take another look at this first handstand. You can see just frozen a little bit underneath where she is supposed to be, but the judges don't see this in slow motion, so I'm sure they probably didn't even catch that.
For Auburn is Drew Watson, another fifth-year senior for the Tigers. She was 2020 first-team All-American on the ball for Auburn just 2 years ago.
Short of that landing. It's a 10-0 start value, 1.5. Looks like she was really going for that stick. Judges would rather see an over-rotated vault instead of under-rotated, and that's what she did here, unfortunately. Not her best tonight.
Well, the Gators, it's the 18-time All-American Trinity Thomas. And for Thomas, I mean, she's an all-around. She does it in everything. Toy, what do you like about her?
Well, she's just an outstanding athlete in NCAA in general. Forget the SEC. She's one of the best gymnasts in the nation. She has scored a 10-0 multiple times on this event. Looking to get another one tonight. So far, no major deductions in this routine. Gearing up for the dismount, looking for that stuck landing. Double layup. Doesn't quite get that stuck landing. Takes a small hop back. But shouldn't be more than a tenth or so. I'm excited to see that score. Take another look at her dismount. It's a double layout. Her feet are absolutely glued together. And like I said earlier, she did take that small hop back. But shouldn't be more than a tenth off.
And still a strong performance for the SEC Gymnast of the Week. That'll transition us to the SEC Freshman of the Week in Suni Lee, the gold medalist from Team USA.
So excited to see this routine from Suni. It's something new. She hasn't done it before here at Auburn. Beautiful. That was at Yurchenko. On layout, half off. Very, very hard to do, and something you don't usually see in NCAA gymnastics, so really nice to see something different. Take another look here. She just has so much power out of this vault, you can almost add another twist. You can see she does take that hop back, but major, major vault.
And for Lee, performing a new routine, how much pressure does that add, especially this environment, with an SEC championship on the line?
It's a lot of pressure for sure, but an athlete like Suni, she's so used to competing under pressure, and she handles it with ease.
Leanne Wong for the Gators, and Wong, a silver medalist at the World Championships not that long ago.
Nice pack salto back to the low bar.
The exhibition.
Gearing up for the dismount. Double out. And just nails it. A little squatty on that dismount, but that's just me being picky. Solid performance.
And for the Gators, they end bars with a little momentum. Toy, how do you want that to carry over in the vault and vice versa for Auburn to bars?
Yeah, it's certainly important to keep that momentum going for both teams. You want to start out strong, but you want to finish strong too.
And for the Auburn Tigers and the Florida Gators, they complete their first rotation. We're through one. We'll head to rotation number two after this timeout. Rotation between Auburn and Florida in the loveliest village on the plains. The Gators a 49.525, Auburn a 49.500. Britt Bowen here with Toy Garcia. And Toy, we've talked about the freshmen that have had an impact for both Florida and Auburn. All right, we have a second color analyst with us tonight, but you look at the freshmen for these two teams, incredible. Suni Lee, one of them for the Auburn Tigers, and also for the Gators. They have Leanne Wong, who also scored a 10 this year on bars.
Absolutely. Really excited to see both of these girls perform tonight. Like you said, they both earned 10-0s in the past, and we're looking to see that again.
And for both of these freshmen, 10s this year. Suni's came just a couple weeks ago at LSU.
Suni is one of the best bar workers in this country, in this world, matter of fact. And it's just amazing to see what she can do. She does it so effortlessly.
Wong, a silver at the World Championships in 2021. Her 10 came back on January 28th against Arkansas. And then, of course, the three-time Olympic medalist in Suni Lee won gold at the World Championships in 2019. She has two perfect 10s this season at LSU and against Kentucky. Toy, doesn't get much better than these two.
It doesn't get much better, and such a treat to watch them tonight.
And for Auburn and Florida, we'll have the second rotation in front of a packed house when we come back. and the Gators. Florida has already won a share of the SEC title. Right now, here's where we stand after the first rotation. The Gators at 49.525 on their bars, and the Auburn Tigers a 49.500 on the vault. We're ready for the second rotation. It'll be the Gators to lead things off with Megan Staggs, followed by Shane Hare, Wong, Reed, Blakely, and Thomas. And after the first rotation, both these teams, Toy, the nerves settled in. They got to get locked in for rotation number two.
Ready to kick things off here. Again, we're looking for the small things. On bars, we're looking for a lot of amplitude, grip, and direction changes. And again, on vault, we're looking for height, distance, and good entry onto the table.
Skaggs, a six-time All-American in her second event of the night after competing fourth for the Gators on bars. Skaggs, the graduate out of Marietta, Georgia, in the leadoff role for the vault.
Huge Yurchenko fall. I was actually expecting to see another half twist out of that. She certainly could have done it, but didn't need to. Such an incredible vault from her. That's exactly how the Gators want to start off on their first competitor on this event.
And now as bars for Auburn, Adeline Sabados lead things off, followed by Groth, Stevens, Brush, Goborn, and Lee. And for Sabados, she is coming off a career high last week against Kentucky with a 9.850.
Sabados has been in and out of the bar lineup this year, but has proven she's more than capable of nailing a good bar routine for this team. A little bit of a leg separation there in that overshoot. Gearing up for the dismount. Double layout. Oh, and she just nails it. Absolutely sticks it. Let's take another look. Huge release there. A Hindorf. And then we'll take another look at her dismounts. A double layout. A little bit of a leg separation on the second layout, but won't be too big of a deduction.
Sabados, an electric performance for Auburn. And now for the Gators, it'll be Savannah Shane Hare taking the floor.
Nice, Yurchenko, 1.5. You could tell she was really going after that stuck landing. Did a little bit of a stutter step on the landing. But we'll take another look. Good entry on the table. A lot of height, good distance. Almost gets that stick, but not quite.
Shane Hare, a second team All-American on vault for the Gators just last year. Solid performance here tonight. And that'll bounce it back to Auburn on the bars. It'll be Sophia Groth, the freshman out of West Des Moines, Iowa. And on bars last week, she had a career high as Groth had a 9.875 against the Wildcats.
Nice. One thing I really love about watching Rose on bars is her line. She just finishes everything all the way out to her big toe. Such a clean performer. So far, no major deductions here. Giant pull into a double back dismount. Exactly what she sought out to do here tonight on bars. Hits that handstand right on top of the bar. And just finishes it with a solid double back dismount. Eases right into that landing.
That sets up Leanne Wong for Florida last week. She had a career high 9.90, their third time tying her career high.
Wow, good ball, but just opens up a little bit early, which is why she landed short.
Tell us about the level of difficulty there, Toy.
A lot of difficulty. This is another ball we don't see that often. It was a Yurchenko half on, Pike half off. Opens up just a little early and with her chest down, which is why she took that step forward.
Cassie Stevens, third up on bars for Auburn, a junior out of Phoenix, Arizona. Another career high for the Tigers last week as Stevens scored a 9.925 on the bars. 2021 All-SEC selection.
Huge Hindorf, major release. Nice overshoot to the low bar. Only thing left here is the dismount. Double layup. Wow! Another stick. Stick after stick after stick. How incredible. Like I mentioned earlier, this is exactly what it's going to take to beat a major team like Florida. It's the details. It's the pointed toes. It's the stuck landing. It's things just like that.
How do they make it look so easy? That's what I'm impressed with.
That's their job, is to make it look easy. But I can assure you, Britt, it is not easy.
Oh, believe me. Nia Reid coming up. Three-time All-American on the vault and floor. She's fourth for the Gators on vault.
Looking for good landings here again, just like on bars. Good entry under the table. 1.5, nicely done, really powerful ball. It does look, the ball looked a little bit flat, but that's me being picky. Would have liked to seen a little bit more amplitude. You can see she kind of bent her arms a little bit on the table, which is why she didn't get enough height as she might have wanted, but all around nicely done.
Aria Brush, the junior out of Cincinnati, coming up for the Tigers. And one of her goals this season, she wants to win a bars title at an event. Toy, that's a specific goal. How do athletes set those, especially when knowing an event is your strength and, hey, you have a chance to compete against the nation's best tonight in Florida?
I would beg to say she picked bars to be an event she had a major goal on because it might not be one of her stronger events. So it's kind of a challenge for her, which is really impressive to see these athletes challenging themselves. And she definitely can earn a first title on this event. As you just saw, that bar team did not have any major deductions. We'll take another look at her huge double layout. Just take that little hop backwards. It'll probably be a 10th or two, but should expect to see nothing lower than a 9.8.
Sloan Blakely up next for the Gators. And for Blakely, this is one of her favorite events, the vault. She had a career high on vault last week with a 9.925.
Wow. Wow, talk about technique. I mean, let's take another look at this. Look at that off the table. Her legs are so tight. She is, her body just in itself is just so tight and so solid. What a great ball. Didn't get that stuck landing, but had a lot of power in that ball.
Darian Goboard up for the second time tonight. Three-time All-American. She won it in bars, or excuse me, was an All-American in bars back in 2020.
Love to see it. Love that connection there. That was a reverse heck to a media pack salto. Judges are also looking for connections for these girls to earn some bonus in their routines. Full twisting double back. Wow. Really impressed tonight with Auburn and their landings on this event specifically. Look at the height there on this Takachev, her major release. just incredible. Really hard to do, folks. And just finish it strong.
Trinity Thomas anchors the vault for the Gators. And for vault, she had a perfect 10 against Alabama just a couple weeks ago.
Britt, take another look. I mean, I can't even in slow motion see anything wrong with that vault.
And that's what her coach, Jenny Rowland, is trying to get her to understand, have that confidence. She has the talent, and when she's performing with confidence, she's unstoppable.
So excited to see what she earned there.
And now you hear the roar for the gold medalist, Sui Lee, won the all-around at the 2020 Games.
What a treat we have here tonight. Two potential 10-0 performances back-to-back.
And she had a perfect 10 on this event at LSU down in Baton Rouge. She did that on the road.
Let's see if Suni can match it.
I think this Auburn crowd would absolutely erupt.
Huge there. Major connection. I mean, every skill in this routine is connected. What? Perfect handstands on top of the bar. Her legs are frozen together and sticks that dismount. I hope they give it to her. She did take a small hop back, but. Take another look here at dismount. I don't know, Britt. What do you think? Was that a stuck landing?
It was close. Happy I am not judging tonight, although I think she has a couple thousand friends in Auburn Arena who would love for that to be a 10. And for the Gators, have an exhibition on the floor, or excuse me, on vault.
Wow, huge Yurchenko pull. Major vault there. I beg to say she'll be in the lineup soon. That was a near perfect vault, and I will remind our viewers, a Yurchenko pull does not start from a 10-0. It's a 9.95 start value.
And Gabby McLaughlin up next for the for the Tigers. It'll be an exhibition on the bars. McLaughlin, a sophomore out of Irving, Texas. McLaughlin had a career high against Kentucky earlier this year on this event.
So far, no major deductions here. Very solid. She's also been in and out of the bar lineup this year for the Tigers. Finished a little bit late on that giant full into an immediate double back. Takes a little bit of a hop out of it, but clean routine.
Oh, the Gators, they get their first perfect 10 of the night. Trinity Thomas on the vault. A stellar finish as the anchor for the Gators through the second rotation in Auburn Arena. More coming up. We're through two rotations here in Auburn. Olivia Hollingsworth has been consistent for Auburn as a beam leadoff all season after coming back from an Achilles injury. But there's more to her story. She's trained with some of the world's best gymnasts. Mackenzie Hamilton has more.
17 years ago, Olivia Hollingsworth felt a spark. as she watched the best of the best compete on gymnastics' biggest stage.
My mom told me that I was watching the Olympics on TV, and I just told her that I wanted to be just like them, so she put me in gymnastics classes.
Years later, Olivia would be training and competing alongside her generation's best, including Simone Biles.
She's kind of like a big sister to me, and she's like helped me a lot, just like grow as a person, just grow in the gym with gymnastics, but also just like outside of the gym. You see her and you want to get to that level, so obviously it like pushes you to be better.
That inspiration drove her to new heights, including the US qualifiers, the American Classic, and eventually Auburn, Alabama. Olivia hit the ground running her freshman season, thriving in the unique culture of college gymnastics.
I didn't really know what it was like coming into college to have like a real team atmosphere. And then like that feeling of like once you finish your routine and the whole team comes up to you and like is hugging you and high-fiving you. It's just like, it's an amazing feeling.
At the end of the season though, Olivia would find herself on the opposite end of those celebrations after suffering an Achilles tear. However, Olivia was determined to grow from this setback.
Once I was allowed to start doing rehab, it was really like, that was when I kind of like flipped the switch. I was like, now is when I really need to put the work in. When I landed my beam routine and I made it, it was an amazing feeling because it felt like I had finally like gotten to that point where I was back to where I wanted to be. My freshman year, I kind of had like the mindset of like, I just need to focus on myself. But with this injury, like you realize that like you have to be there for the team. Like it maybe if you're not on the actual event, the people on the side are just as important because you have to cheer your team on. My goal going into beam, like when I'm first, is to just set everybody else up. So I want to do the best routine that I can do so that maybe my teammates can get a 10.
Oh, sorry.
Championship night for the Florida Gators and the Auburn Tigers. Auburn Tigers up on beam. Olivia Hollingsworth leading things off, followed by Brush, Stevens, Groth, McLaughlin, and Lee. Toy, you've seen Auburn a time or two this year. What do you think of the Tigers on beam?
Well, this is their best event this year. They're second in the SEC and ranked fourth nationally. So that's a huge, huge deal for this team. They've come a really long way. I want to remind our viewers what the judges are looking for on this event. Acrobatic skills, with and without flight, turns and leaps.
And for Hollingsworth, going to lead things off out of Seabrook, Texas. And we just saw the feature on her coming back from the injury. So for Hollingsworth, always glad to get back into your competitive mindset, because that's not easy, Toy, coming back from injury. And to come back at this level has been impressive.
Full turn there. Every athlete is required to have a full turn on the beam. Double acro series by Hanson. Step out, layout, step out. Right on top of the beam. Switch leg leap to a switch quarter into a beat jump. Judges are looking for 180 splits here to get full credit. Only thing left here is her dismount. Side aerial to a layout full and sticks it. Leads the Tigers with a solid performance, exactly what she needs to do.
That's a stick for Olivia Hollingsworth. Let's hear it.
Olivia Hollingsworth leading things off for the Tigers. For Florida on the floor, it'll be Megan Skaggs, followed by Richards, Bowman, Wong, Reed, and Blakely.
First up on floor for the Gators.
Skaggs first up again out of Marietta, her third event of the night. She's in the all-around for the Gators.
Floor is by far my favorite event to watch. It was my favorite event to perform. We get to see so much personality from these athletes. Judges are looking for harmony between acrobat and dance. Use of the entire floor and changes in rhythm. First pass here. Front handspring layout, 1.5. To a jump, a lot of athletes will do this on the event to eliminate any potential steps on the landing. Each floor routine lasts 1.5 minutes. It requires a lot of endurance, high energy. These athletes need to be engaged the entire time, and most importantly, they need to have fun. That's what the judges are looking for too, just for these athletes to have fun.
That's what Skaggs said, that gymnastics helps break out her shy side. Well, this is the event to do that.
Absolutely, you'll see a lot of introverts get out there and perform, and you'll never know that they have a shy personality because they're basically on the stage doing what they love to do. That was a double salto pass there. Each gymnast is required to have a double salto on the floor and finishes routine with 2 passes, and nicely done.
So the Gators have their first performance on floor in the book. And of course, if you come to Neville Arena, you can't forget the gymnastics in the AU Jungle student section.
So funny, they have been around for so long. I graduated here in 2013, and they were here when I was a gymnast, and they were here before me, so it's been years and years that the gymnastics have supported the Auburn Tigers.
And for the Tigers, it'll be Aria Brush as the second ball performer, or excuse me, the second beam performer.
There's that required full turn. Front aerial to split jump. Good connection there. Every athlete on this event is required to move backwards, forwards, or sideways. Back handspring layout, step out. Good double acro series from her. Unlike any other event, beam requires just a calm mindset. And that's hard to do when you're in a packed arena with 8,000 to 9,000 people, but you really just have to do what you do in practice and remain in your bubble.
Well, for Brush, she wants to be more consistent. I feel like this is the hardest event to be consistent on. Why is that, Toy?
Well, a lot of people don't know this, but the beam is 4 feet high and only 4 inches wide. So if you're having problems with confidence, flipping and twisting on an apparatus like this, I could understand. But she handled this with no problem. She had a lot of confidence in this routine. And we'll take another look at her acro series. It's a handspring layout step out and handles it with ease.
So the Tigers 2 down. On the beam, it'll be Peyton Richards, a junior out of Illinois, up for the Gators on the floor. Read in her bio, I thought this about her family being from Illinois. Her name was inspired after a famous Chicago athlete. I'll let you take a guess. Her first name, Peyton. Her brother, Jordan, also inspired by another famous athlete, MJ and Walter Peyton.
Huge double layout opening pass. That's an E-level skill, which is the hardest skill you can perform in gymnastics. Beautiful leap sequence there. I'm gonna remind our viewers that judges are, like the beam, are looking for a complete 180 split in order to get full credit for the pass.
Richards last week had a season high 9.850 on the floor in the win over OU.
Nicely done, her second pass, second and final pass there. Clean routine from her. You'll see a lot of NCAA athletes performing only 2 passes now. That's all they'll need. take another look at her first pass, though. It's a D-level skill, excuse me, E-level skill. Lands it perfectly. We'll take another look at her last pass. Her double acro.
A 9.925.
And for the Tigers, Cassie Stevens up on beam, and she was an SEC all-freshman team selection on beam her freshman year in 2020. And Toy, this is her favorite event.
And I could understand why. She has a skill named after her on this event. We'll see it here in just a minute. First things first, though, her double acro series, the big handspring step out into an immediate layout step out, right on top of the beam, no problems there. Nice split jump to double ring stag into a B jump. And here it is. This is called the Stevens, a skill that was named after her. So cool.
Wow. To have a skill named after you. And she did it with perfection.
Only thing left here is the dismount. It's a round off, 1.5 twists. Wow. And we can see why the Tigers are ranked number 4 nationally on this event. The Stevens, there it is right there. And a stuck dismount. What else could you ask for, Britt?
Strong performance by Stevens and the Tigers, but the Gators also performing well tonight. Have Alyssa Bowman up next on floor. 5'1 graduate out of Dallas, Texas. Averaging a 9.864. Pretty solid there for the Gators, Toy.
Showing some flexibility there. Another reason why I love this event is the athletes get to show a lot of their personality here. And a lot of their strengths. Double twisting, double acro there.
For the personality, Toy, how can athletes add a personality floor and make that one of the strengths of their floor routine?
Well, for me, for example, I'm in high energy. I was a high energy athlete, so my floor routine kind of showcased that, while others, my teammates, were more artistic and dance-like, so their routine showcased that. They had a lot of acrobatic, showing a lot of flexibility and showing their strengths. So that's what's so fun about this event, is that you have time to do that. You have a minute and a half to dance on the floor and show what you're capable of. And finishing with the Gator Chomp. Solid performance there.
And you can see Bowman, she is fired up, rightfully so, for the Gators.
First pass here. A lot of height on those twisting acro skills. Second and last pass, double pike.
And it's back to the Tigers on beam. The freshman, Sophia Groth. And for Groth, she had a 9.950 twice this year on this event. That's her season high. The second came last week.
I love watching Groth on beam. She's such a beautiful athlete on this event. Much like Bars, she has such pretty lines and finishes every skill all the way out to her fingertips. That was so impressive there. That was a triple series. Back handspring, step out to a layout, step out to another back handspring, step out. She covered the full length of the beam, which is 16 feet long.
Well, she did say this was her favorite event because it's the most challenging. I found that interesting.
Nice front layout. She is having a good time up there. She's smiling from ear to ear, as she should be. Linking left is the dismount, looking for a stuck landing, side aerial to a layout pull. Falls a little bit out of that landing, but wow, well done. I'm really excited to see the score. Shouldn't be anything lower than a 9-9. I did not see any major deductions here, if any at all. Let's take another look at her leap path. Wow, complete 180, which is so hard to do.
Next up on floor, Groth getting the shades for Auburn. Leanne Wong takes the floor for the Gators, and she's been good this year on the floor. She's won the all-around twice, and her best floor performance came against LSU, but she won four against Missouri.
Wow, beautiful. That was a triple twist. That's also an E-level pass. Don't see a lot of those in NCAA gymnastics, so that was very cool to see. Interesting fact about Wong, she was absent for a whole semester to train for Worlds, so yeah. She's still learning and adjusting to college gymnastics. It's very different than anything that she's accustomed to. She's a hard worker, Roland said. She's low maintenance, which you don't see a lot of the time for freshman athletes.
And Jenny Roland was so complimentary of that as well.
Fell a little bit out of that second pass there, but she was able to recover okay. Wow, beautiful double pike to finish off. Really pretty performer on this event. Take a look at her second pass here. The only major or minor deduction I saw here. You can see she fell out of that a little bit, but she recovered quickly. That's how you know you're a veteran. Knowing where you are, body awareness, we call it cat-like reflexes in gymnastics.
Recovered well after that second pass. It's up to Gabby McLaughlin for Auburn, the sophomore out of Irving, Texas. And this is an event she's familiar with. She competed in all nine meets for the Tigers on beam just last year. Her goal, though, everybody's goal, she wants to get a 10, a perfect 10 on beam this year. She'll have a chance right here.
So she hit two requirements there just now. Switch leg leap into backhandspring layout, step out. She hit her leap series and she hit her double acro. Connected them, made it easy for her. B jump to a side aerial. Moving right into the dismount. But not yet. That was her leap series, switch leg leap to straddle quarter. Jam-packed routine here, has a lot of elements. Now we will see the dismount. Gainer off the front of the beam and handles it with no problem. That should be a really high scoring routine.
That's a stick, everyone, for Gabby McLaughlin.
Nice switch leg leap into her backhand spring layout step out. And we'll see the dismount where she just eases right into it and nails it.
And a great landing there by McLaughlin.
Next up on floor.
McLaughlin all smiles as we transition back to floor to the senior in Nia Reed out of Landover, Maryland. And she's already won this event once this year against Arkansas with a 9.95. And she did have a career high 10 against Alabama. All-American at this event.
Already know it's a high energy routine. Love the music, showing a little bit of sass here. Wow, first pass is a huge double layout. That's an E-level skill. Floor routine and floor music are typically decided between the coaches and the athlete, whatever they're comfortable with and what they want to do the next year or the current year. She is so powerful on this event. She gets so much height in her passes and her leaps. Last pass here. Double pike. Wow. So much control in that landing. Exactly what the judges are looking for. And finishes with the gator chomp. First pass here, wow, double layout. Her feet are just absolutely glued together. And last pass here, same thing. She just eases right into that. She didn't even need to take that step back, which by the way, there's no deduction for that. Gymnasts are allowed to do that. But just so controlled, so nicely done.
And the All-American does it again for Florida. For Auburn, it's the freshman gold medalist, Suni Lee, who last week Toy had a perfect 10. Mentally, how do you come back from a perfect performance to try to replicate that the next week?
Well, I would say you're excited. I would say you're eager to do it again. Yeah. Get back up on the beam and do it again in front of your home team, your home crowd.
Suni certainly a crowd favorite on the Plains. I think not only is the Auburn family Toy taken to her, but she's taken to the Auburn family.
Beautiful. Front layout, excuse me, front aerial to back handspring step out to layout step out. No balance checks, no form breaks. Does it again right there in her lead pass, complete 180s, right on top of the beam. So far, no major deductions here. Dismount. Wow, what do you think, Britt? It's 10-0 worthy for sure.
Incredible. I know the crowd loved it.
I mean, there were really no visible errors at all. Take a look at her acro pass. And her dismount just sticks it. I mean, that was just the cherry on top of that routine. Beautifully done. Very impressive.
Sloan Blakely. Up next on floor, but the crowd erupts. Another perfect 10 for the gold medalist, Suni Lee. Back-to-back weeks for the freshman.
I have chills, Britt. The energy in here is insane. But let's take a look at Flora and the Gators. She does a double Arabian, huge pass for her. That's an E-level skill. Also a blind landing, very hard to do because you don't see the ground when you're landing.
Waterford Sloan, credit to her to stay poised as the crowd erupting, staying calm, cool, and collective. All the respect in the world for that student athlete.
Absolutely, and that's a professional right there. That's how you know these athletes train 20 plus hours a week. Double back, second pass. Gator jump. Last pass here. Double salto. Just star-studded performances, one after the other. Let's take another look at her E-level pass. It was her first pass. It's a double Arabian. Huge there. And her last pass, her double acro. She's so excited, just nails it.
Florida, each rotation toy, you're seeing how deep this Gator team is. And man, they bring it one after the other. And really no rotations in the, or excuse me, no weaknesses in these rotations in the lineup tonight. Another exhibition for Auburn. It'll be on Beam with Morgan Lee Oldham.
She's been in Beam lineup in and out the past year or two, 3 years that she's been in Auburn. She's been in and out of this lineup, and she's very capable of scoring really high for her team. Nice acro series there. Backhander step out to layout, step out.
And that was Blakely, right? You want to go to the 10 next?
Side aerial there. Nice single skill. Split jump to a ring stacked. Gearing up for the dismount here. Side aerial to a layout full off the beam. Nicely done. I know she's got to be proud about that one.
And the Gators just got a huge reaction from a perfect 10 from Sloan Blakely. Her first career perfect 10 on floor.
3 tenths tonight in this arena. I mean, the feeling is palpable in here. Everyone is so excited.
Yeah, the Gators have two, and Blakely with a second. SUNY Lee for Auburn just got one on vault moments ago. Chloe Clark will have an exhibition on floor. Always wanted to be a Gator, and she's got that opportunity in her second year out of Denver, Colorado.
Nice double salto pass there, twisting both elements back to back, good connections. Just by a little bit on that lead pass there. Gearing up for her final pass. Double back. She's a little squatty. You can see she crunched her ankles just ever so slightly.
And that completes the third rotation for both Auburn and Florida. When we come back, we'll have a score update as the Gators and Tigers compete for an SEC regular season championship. Flag surf in full effect in Neville Arena through three rotations between the Gators and the Tigers. Third-ranked Florida has a 149 score, and the Auburn Tigers has a 148-775 score. Megan Skaggs of Florida is coming in as a graduate and has a big heart and a passion for community service. Here's more on Skaggs and what her mission is through gymnastics.
The Tenable Project's mission is to inspire, impact, and empower. And it was born over the summer with a close friend of mine, Corey. We brainstormed the whole idea and really just wanted to figure out how I could use this additional gifted year of competing for the Gators and doing gymnastics to give back, because the sport has given me so much. And this year is not anything that I ever imagined or anticipated that I would get to do. So using it to give back is really just my thank you to the sport and to everyone who supported me along the way.
What a special mission for Megan Skaggs and the Tiny Bow Project. And one thing I've learned, her bows are part of her routine. If you watch her tonight, you will see the bows toy. I just think it's so cool for her to be able to represent this project every night she competes for the Gators. And how about that? Not only impacting the Gators on the floor, but more so in the community for the Florida Gators.
Absolutely. These athletes are so busy. Every hour of their time is blocked off for practice, studying, meetings, you name it. So it's so nice to see that they step out of their world and do something to help the community.
It has been a fun night in Auburn Arena. We have one rotation left. When we come back, the fourth and final rotation between the Auburn Tigers and the... Let's take a look at the most up-to-date SEC Women's Basketball Tournament bracket. Three of the four teams are set for the SEC Tournament semifinal. Only Tennessee and Alabama remain coming up later tonight. And here's a look at your score through three rotations in Neville Arena between Auburn and the Florida Gators. The Gators with a 149-000, Auburn with a 148-775. Toy, we have had some high scores tonight. And here's a look, two perfect 10s for Florida, one for Auburn. We've had 5-9-9, 5-0s or better for each team. Just absolutely incredible.
Absolutely. I don't know that there's ever been a 10-0 in the Auburn Arena or now Neville Arena. So I'm so happy that we were here to see it, and so was everyone else, 8,000 other people here tonight.
Well, the Gators, they will start off the fourth rotation on the beam. It'll be Megan Skaggs, followed by Blakely Bowman, Wong Thomas, and Clapper. And for the Gators, one rotation, Toy. They are one rotation away from winning their fourth outright regular season championship.
I mean, there's still one rotation left. You never know what's going to happen. We've seen some crazy things in NCAA gymnastics, so always important to keep the momentum going to the very end.
All right, fans, let's get started with our fourth rotation.
Again, it'll be Megan Skaggs, the graduate out of Marietta, Georgia. And she's had 3 9-9-5s in her career on beam. She's had one this year against Kentucky back on February 18th. She was the 2019 balance beam champion in the SEC.
Nice whoop turn there. Very hard to do down low on the beam. Known for her 180 complete splits. She does it again. Double acro series there by Kanti Sabataleo. Step out, no problems. Front aerial, solid there. That was her single skill. She is cool as a cucumber up there. Very nice switch side there. Just the dismount. It's a side aerial to a layout full and just does what Skag does. Nailed the routine.
Well, Skaggs, like the rest of her teammates from Florida, so impressive and so fun to watch this Florida Gator team. Here's the floor lineup and the final rotation for the Auburn Tigers. Sarah Hubbard leads it off, followed by Watson, Stevens, Groth, Lee, and Goboard. And for Hubbard last week, coming off a career high, had a 9-9-0-0 against Kentucky.
First pass, wow, full in. Huge, that's an E-level skill. That looked super easy.
You said that looked easy.
She made it look easy, how about that? Gearing up for the second pass here. Had a little bit of an error there. That second pass looked like it was meant to be a front layout. She tucked it a little bit. So she might not have made it to her feet otherwise, but nice save there. Huge off the floor. That was a tucked full in. Take a look at her second pass here. You can see she bends her legs actually going into that second flip, which is why she would not have made it all the way to her feet if she laid it out completely like it was intended to be.
One down on beam and floor is back to the beam for Sloan Blakely and the Florida Gators. And for Blakely, freshman out of Frisco, Texas, had a 9-9-5-0 last week in this event. Toy, that's a career high, and it came against the number two team in the country, Oklahoma.
So impressed when gymnasts can score high on beam, because for me, it was such a hard event, and for a lot of other gymnasts, it's the hardest event for them. So I've always been so impressed when I see high scores like SUNY and like this athlete right here. Yeah. So far, nothing major to report. A little bit of a balance check there, but she moves out quickly to recover. And finishes with a dismount, a side aerial to a layout full. Takes a small, small hop forward on that landing. Take another look. Little bit of a balance check. You can see she bent over and straightened her legs. Shouldn't be more than a tenth or so, though.
Still all smiles after that performance, and Auburn gonna rely on their fifth year, Drew Watson. Another career high for the Tigers last week. Watson with a 9.925 against Kentucky, and she is one of the anchors of this team.
Drew's capable of a huge opening pass. We'll see if she does it tonight, and she does. It's a double Arabian. If you notice, some athletes have that 4-inch mat on the floor. There's no deductions there. The athletes are allowed to use that. Kind of gives them a little extra padding on their landings. No problems on our double acro pass. This is kind of the dance portion for a lot of these gymnasts in between their second and third pass. Time to regroup and catch their breath a little bit as much as they can. Last pass here. Solid double tuck. She had a lot of power coming out of that one.
Watson looked to her student section after the performance.
Huge E-level opening pass. That's a double Arabian, a blind landing, hard to do. You can't see the floor. Double salto and finishes with a double tuck. Had a lot of power coming out of that one, but she was able to regain her footing.
My favorite thing, Toy, is watching the excitement from both Florida and Auburn after they finish a strong routine. And a lot of good energy here tonight. Alyssa Bowman, 8-time All-American, up next on the beam. Bowman, a 3-time SEC beam champion in 18, 19, and 2021.
She looks so confident up there. Strong and steady. Looks like she missed a connection there. Let's see if she'll make it up somewhere else. And she does, right there. Side aerial to split jump. She recovered very nicely. The judges probably won't even notice. These gymnasts are trained to do that. Finishes strongly with a round up 1.5 twist dismount. Nice 180 split leap. Wow, perfect 180 split there. Showing a lot of flexibility. And that stuck landing right on the target.
Solid there by the 3-time SEC champion, Alyssa Bowman. Back to floor for Auburn. And it's Cassie Stevens. Stevens, career high 9.900 against the Cats just last week.
First pass, front layout to a front layout 1.5. There's the Stevens there. She does it on floor two.
And remind people, the Stevens.
Lost her balance a little bit there on that second jump. Thank you. Last pass here. Double top. Nails it. Right on the money. Little errors here and there. A tenth or two, 0.2 maybe. Take a look at her first pass. No errors here, however. That was her double salto, front layout to 1.5 twists. Last pass just sticks it and finishes strong.
Strong indeed for Cassie Stevens. Transitioning back to Leanne Wong in Florida. Wong, a freshman.
Wong is so poised on this event. So beautiful to watch. Right on top of the beam, but can't bring a step out.
Wong, what a bronze at the U.S. Championships in this event in 2019.
Wow, love to see that switch leg ring leap. Round off, double full, sinks right into that landing. Back handspring step out right on top of the balance beam. And a little bit of a harder dismount at NCAA. We don't see a lot of double full dismounts, so nice to see that she's challenging herself.
And a freshman at that, challenging herself. Fourth in the rotation, that was Leanne Wong embracing her head coach, Jenny Rowland of the Gators. Sophia Groff. Coming to the floor, a 5'3 freshman out of West Des Moines, Iowa. Already seen her in a couple of events tonight for Auburn.
First pass is a front handspring, double full twist. Also an E level skill. Beautiful leap pass there. Really nicely done on the execution. This athlete is so clean on her skills on every event I've seen her perform on tonight. Really pretty to watch. Last pass here. Front handspring, 1.5 twists. Finishes it with such excitement.
Wong all smiles after that performance.
Take another look at her first pass. It's a front handspring double full twist. She is thrilled to have nailed that. And same here with her last pass. So exciting to watch her.
Next on beam, Trinity Thomas.
Trinity Thomas up next on beam. Thomas already turning heads tonight. She had a perfect 10 on vault. Here she is with a chance on beam.
I love to see cool mounts on the beam. for her acro series. Had a little bit of a balance check there. You can see she turned to the side. That was a one-arm back handspring layout step out. That's worth more than a regular back handspring step out. A lot more difficult. A lot of amplitude and height on that front aerial. Nicely done. Good connections there. Front aerial to beat jump to immediate splash down to the beam. By the way, every athlete is required to have a down on the beam element. Side aerial to a full twisting layout. Take another look. Front aerial to this triple connection there. And then the dismount here. Wow, just eases right into that landing with her hips wide open, sees the landing and finishes perfectly.
Trinity Thomas can do it all for the Florida Gators, and she has proven that time and time again tonight and throughout the season. But another person who can do it all is the gold medalist in the all-around for the Olympic Games, and Suni Lee. Here she is for her final performance on floor for the Tigers. Suni needing a 9-9 to win the all-around tonight for Auburn.
Let's see if she can do it here. Opening pass is a double layout. Huge E-level skill. The feeling in here is so intense. All eyes on Suni right now. She's so fun to watch. It's just the last pass here. Let's see if she can get that 9-9 that she needs. And I think she's done it. What a night for Suni.
Suni Lee. She is no stranger to the big stage. She hit on all cylinders tonight.
Huge double layup there. You can see a little bit of a leg separation on that E-level pass. But amazing job, nevertheless.
One more gymnast for both Auburn and Florida for the Gators. Leah Clapper out of Ann Arbor, Michigan will serve as the anchor.
Anchor position for beam and the last event for your team, always a tough spot to be in. And she crumbles a little bit under the pressure. That was a triple series there, hard to do. It was back handspring layout step out to another immediate layout step out. Be a 5-10 deduction there for her.
Well, it's tough to swallow. She does have a perfect 10 in her career in this event, and her season high was against LSU. Out of 9.75.
And I think that's the only fall we've seen tonight.
Yeah. And she won this event against Auburn last year with a 9.975.
Finishes strong with her dismount. Such a bummer. Could have been a high scoring routine for the Gators, but fortunately they scored well enough where they will not have to count this routine. We'll take another look at her series, and she kind of just peels off on the side and jumps off. Wasn't able to regain focus and stay on the beam.
For Auburn, it comes down to Darian Goborn, the final performer of the night, the senior out of Sarasota, Florida. Three-time All-American, 2021 SEC Co-Specialist of the Year. Toy, what does Auburn and Daria need out of this performance here?
Well, I think she's probably looking for a 10 tonight. What do you think, Britt?
Well, we've seen a lot of 10s, two from Auburn and three from Florida. Or excuse me, two from Florida.
Having some issues with the music.
And as a gymnast, you notice she walks off and resets. How important is that when there's an issue with music?
You know, that's really tough, and you can actually see the Gators walking over to support her. That messes with you mentally. Yeah. It really does. So here we go again. Yeah. Starting over.
I love what you said, Florida walking up to support her. It, great respect between these two teams.
And there's the signature move from her, the crown on the queen. Always like to mention and remind our viewers that she does that without grabbing her legs. Her hips are completely open. It's hard to do, trust me when I say. Showing a little bit of personality here. The crowd loves this routine. Double salto, nails it. Only thing left is the double pike, last pass. Boom. She's pretty satisfied with that. Knocks it out of the park.
Go, board. Oh, you hear the crowd.
You think it'll be a 10, Britt?
It would be huge if so. Here's another look at that first pass.
First pass here, huge. Completely open hip, double tuck. Showing a little bit of attitude and sass, what she's known for. And last pass here, if you can feel what this energy is like in this arena, oh my God, she got a 10.
That is a career high for the senior out of Sarasota. Another 10 for the orange and blue.
Wow, I have chills, Britt. This is incredible. This is a historical night in this arena, truly.
And this is a historical night for both teams. And with that 10, the Auburn Tigers have tied the Florida Gators. Have to wait for official results, but as of right now, it is a tie.
Speechless. I feel speechless.
Well, and if it's a tie, Toy, this is big, because Auburn needs a win to get a share of the SEC championship. A tie, Florida is still the outright SEC champion. But regardless, that would be an incredible result for these two teams to finish neck and neck in a tie. All right, for the four rotations, we are going to take a break. We'll have the final scores when we come back. An electric atmosphere tonight in the loveliest village on the plains. Back inside Auburn Arena, a historic night, a tie between the number three Florida Gators and the number six Auburn Tigers, a 198.575 for both teams tonight. Walking you back courtside to Neville Arena, Britt Bowen alongside Toy Garcia and Toy. What a night. I mean, how do you put this one into words?
By the way, thank you for doing that.
Hey, that's what teammates are
screaming for during the break, because this is incredible. This is some of the best gymnastics I have seen in my 30 years on this planet. So I'm so happy to be a part of this, and I am so happy for the Auburn Tigers tonight.
All-around champion tonight, the Olympic gold medalist, Suni Lee. A stellar performance by the freshman.
Opened up tonight with her new vault she did, earned a 10-0 on bars. Nailed her floor routine, nailed her beam routine, moved into the floor lineup tonight. Really just outstanding performances for her. She had a stellar night.
And tonight, here's your leader, Suni with a 10 on beam. Trinity Thomas with a 10 on vault. Auburn and Lee had a 9.95 on bars, along with Wong of Florida on the floor. Blakely and Goborn each with a 10. And this is the most 10s I have ever seen, ever. And I don't mean just live. I mean just in any meet that I paid attention to. Incredible.
Absolutely incredible, and I can agree with you. It's the most 10s I have seen. That 198.575 all-around score for Auburn. It's the record. It's incredible. I want to remind our viewers that a perfect score is a 200. So they were less than a point and a half away from a near perfect score. And it's just, I mean, it's really, really exciting for them.
School record for the Auburn Tigers, but the fourth SEC regular season championship for the Florida Gators. Florida has won it with a tie tonight in Auburn Arena. Again, a tie did not warrant Auburn a share of the title. Florida stays perfect for the third consecutive year in the SEC. And boy, these Gators, led by head coach Jenny Rowland, I mean, they are so fun to watch. Both of these teams, these athletes, so fun to watch and so fun to celebrate.
Yeah, and again, I'm so excited to have been here tonight. It is really, it's historic for Auburn, truly.
For Toy Garcia, I'm Britt Bowen, saying so long from Auburn Arena, where the final score, a tie, 198.575 for both Auburn and Florida. Be sure to tune into the SEC Network Saturday, March 19th for the SEC Gymnastics Championships. Session 1 begins at 3:30 Eastern, followed by Session 2 at 8 Eastern. To watch this match, it's in entirety, visit the ESPN app or watch ESPN.com. This has been a presentation of ESPN.